Hey, Mr. Megalis here. How are you?
Man, you guys look good.
You look like you got some sun. You been outside? Yeah. Man, it's summertime. Get out there. Get a suntan.
I'm not suntanning. That's bullshit, man.
But people are still out there like slathering. Let that bake you till you're just like a piece of leather and you get big splotches on you. It's no big deal. They just cut those out.
You get a big, like, sort of big old
thing
black
there,
mark that's festering and cut.
Take a knife and they just cut that
you're
out.
You're good. But you got a tan, which says that you are successful and you got time for leisure.
You know what you can really do to, like, take yourself off the planet, like, even faster?
Go outside, lay in the sun,
good old oil all over
all
you.
All over, oil everywhere.
And smoke a cigarette and drinking Jack.
Yeah, and then have someone, like, with a big board just
whacking you in the back of the head, too.
That'd be great.
Hello? Speaking of that,
man, Bret Michaels. He's all right, man. He's a survivor. That guy made it.
You know, his head was exploding.
Appendix, like, shot out of his body.
A big hole growing in his
heart. And he is living.
And I'm thinking, wow, man, it's like rock and roll is a healer.
Live forever with rock and roll.
That's not really true. Most rockers, like, die so fast because they, like, groupies. Groupies will kill you.
Stay away from the groupies.
Just play your music. And then when the ladies
just
come
say
up,
no thank you.
What is that, beer?
No thank you.
What is that, marijuana?
No thank
right,
you.
Right, but Bret's doing it.
God bless him, man. He's a new hero of mine.
Even though he's got that funky sort of bandana with the fake hair,
that's
got
to be one piece. Is there a Halloween costume, a Bret Michaels Halloween costume?
If there ain't, Halloween people, get on that. That's a good idea.
It's going to be a big one this October.
Bret Michaels.
So what else? I don't know.
It's like June. They have not plugged the hole as of yet. The oil's still,
and they got all kinds of ideas.
Obama did nothing for like a long while.
It's okay. Everything's great.
He sort of looks the same at everything.
Right. Disaster. That's terrible.
Birthday party.
Great.
Let's shoot a couple hoops.
Great. Right.
He always kind of has that Obama look.
That Obama look.
I don't know if it's just guy under control or freaking dummy.
I'm not saying dummy book. Dummy.
Sort of. Smarty congressional
dummy.
He should have had his ass down there with a freaking bucket.
Day one,
a bucket, little sand bucket,
and little thongs, and a little bucket, and
little,
like,
shovel.
A little 2-3-year-old.
Where's the oil? I can tell you. I'll put the oil in
there. That's what he should have done. Or better yet,
he should have, like, kicked BP out of our Gulf a long time ago.
But he won't, you know, because there's some kind of weird shit going on. They went on there, started backroom politics, elected, and stuff like
that. Blinders on, blinders.
What are they doing on the fucking Gulf?
I don't know what's going on. We don't know what's happening behind
the scenes.
It took
a lot of money to get Obama elected. Millions of dollars. And oil guys, you know,
$50 million for you. When we go out in the Gulf and we pollute it and could destroy your entire country, you just look away, okay?
Great. You know,
see eye to eye in this thing, don't you?
Hey, I'm
going to pollute your Gulf.
BP!
One guy, what did he say? President BP? You know, like, no one is more upset than me. I mean, I want my life back.
Oh, I want my life back, just like it was. Rich man from England enjoying his days. Yes, I don't want to worry about 11 people I killed or the Gulf I've polluted.
Oh, yeah, dick! Your life will never be the same. You killed 11 people.
11 people dead, burned up alive,
into the water.
And they don't even mention those people.
But you want your little life
back. That's right.
You plan to stay there and bring it all back.
Even if it takes for 20, 30 days,
I'll be there for you, people of the
Gulf. I'll be there for
you. Yes, I will.
Oh, you will.
You're not.
This
shit's polluted for, like, the next, like, 75 years. What are you going to be doing, Mr. President of BP?
You're a little bit of cheating.
I'm having a little bit of tea.
What happened back there?
It was terrible. It was spilled out there.
I want my life back. I want hot water there.
Ah. It's because we left you, huh? Because we screwed you back in the 1700s. Is that what all this is about? Payback's a bitch. Is that what you're telling us? It's payback, isn't it?
We're going to take care of it. You know why? Kevin Costner's on it. Oh, great.
Bring on the Hollywood actors.
What's Tom Hanks doing? What's
can we get some from Kanye West?
Excuse me, I mean, I'm gonna let you talk in a second, but I got a way to plug this little oil thing here.
Huh? Okay? How about Tim Burton? Maybe he can, like, get Johnny Depp with a time machine.
Back before this happened. Yes.
We're screwed, people. We are screwed.
Anymore. I used to go down there all the time, down to Captiva, Sanibel, loving the Gulf.
Enjoying
the waters, pristine waters.
Getting, like, fish out of there.
Groupers,
get a little, eating that beautiful fish. Now, those fishermen are, they're done.
What are they going to do?
You're going to go down there and hang out on the beach while the oil just kind of laps up.
She's got a nice sheen tonight.
That's great. You know what? I think I can walk from here all the way to Mexico on that oil.
Like a big waterbed. Great. Great. Thanks, BP.
We are so screwed.
And then BP's like, okay, we screwed the fisherman's life here, didn't we? It's okay, we're going to put you to work. You know, get your little suit on, get your little bucket, start scooping up the oil there. We'll pay you for that. We'll pay you for that.
Yeah, right. And those fishermen are like breathing that. It's like they're like, yeah.
Oh, is this part of my lung here?
Before it's all said and done, man, lots of things are going to die. The land's ruined. Fishermen are going to die.
Because they've been like poisoned by these British Petroleum people.
Now, I know we need oil. I know we freaking need oil.
I use it in my car.
I don't run on air or leaves.
But we got to do something.
We got to.
It's going to happen again and again and again and again.
Because, you know, those oil companies, it's not just BP. It's all of them. Everywhere they go, it's like, disaster.
Because they're trying to, like, make money.
And when you're trying to make money, huh? What's the most important thing? People safety? Fish? Clean water? Clean air? No.
Money.
The money.
That's right. That's all they care about.
No matter how much this like curly-headed British guy, no matter what he says, I want my life back.
And Obama's saying, it stops here. Yeah. I'm responsible, you know, I'm
stops here. Is that your company? Obama and BP's not your company.
I'm responsible, yep, stops here. I'll be here for you. We're not leaving.
Something's weird there. Obama shouldn't be apologizing.
What he should be doing is strapping those guys up with
big wood spinny things,
and we all should have turns like throwing little darts at these bastards.
Oops, sorry, hit you in the testicles.
I want my testicles back. I'm sorry, everybody. I'm sorry, people of the Gulf. I'm sorry, fishermen. I'm sorry, freaking fish. I wish I could apologize. Sucks. But some Hollywood actor is going to have a great idea and save us. I bet it's going to be Steven Seagal. He's got a lot of ideas. Or is just going to kick some ass.
I thought that we could work it out, but